a story, in a sense, I would like to believe is the record or a narration of a certain incident. So basically, everything that we are doing, or even this interaction that we are having, I'm talking into camera, is a story. Now, it all depends on how I wish to present this story. And when I'm presenting this story, I think I have to understand one thing very clearly, that this particular story will not appeal to everybody. So I think as one of the fundamental things about communication would mean that one has to identify who this story is meant for. Once I know that this story is meant for this person, then I will know how to engage with this person. If I try to make this story for everybody, then I will not know how to engage with this person. In this story, there has to be a certain sense of drama. By drama, I mean that it's that kind of adhesive that you add to the story, in the craft, in the way you layer your story, the way you introduce certain facets and characters, which actually then makes the story what we would call very gripping. And when we are talking about a story being gripping, we have to understand that from my perspective, I could be hearing a story which to me is something that I have perhaps not experienced. So therefore, it is possibly a story which I have not really come across. It's a situation, it could be even a country, it could be even happening in some place. From happening in a place which I don't know to happening in a particular phase in the world's history, or for that matter, supernatural. So in all this, what I think is very important is to acknowledge the fact that at every stage, my recipient, the person who I am narrating this story to, is also approaching my story with a certain rational mind. And it is possible that the person is always thinking of challenging my story, because that's the way we behave, which is that I don't want to accept anything which is presented to me at a certain face value. So I would always want to think that, is this the right thing that he's saying? Is this something that is possible? So therefore, like in a film, we believe in this whole concept of suspension of disbelief. There has to be something in the crafting, something in the way I build credibility into my story, that you will stop questioning. My way of telling you this whole story, my way of narrating it, must be such that beyond a point, you will stop questioning, you will only listen. And that, I think, is so true when we are talking about presentations or any of these things, that when we start off, the person who is hearing me, the group, the room, is filled of people who are all questioning this: who is this man, what is he, who is he, what is he trying to do, what is he trying to achieve, why is he like this, why does he have that mannerism. All these things are there. So that is the time when there are many barriers between me as the presenter, as the one who is narrating a story, and my audience. So in this room, I have to quickly break down all those barriers to make it such that they should start believing in what I am saying, because I have made certain gestures, I have made certain references, I have made certain kind of ways in which I have connected, or I have been able to establish that I'm saying something that they should listen to with an open mind. Now, that I think is also the role of suspension of disbelief, which I have. Now, that has to be built at a stage that for the rest of the journey, there is meant to be no more questions. So I believe that, these principles, if we sort of build into our way in which we sort of construct a kind of a narrative, whether we want to write it or we want to sort of put together as a business document, this aspect has to be remembered, that we are at all stages, no matter whether it's a very serious business plan or whatever, there is always the need to believe that I am presenting something to somebody who will not necessarily believe me, who will not necessarily trust me. So in the first few sections, there has to be something to make my audience start believing, building that trust, and almost willing to sort of become my audience, or almost like my pupil, if I were to look at myself as a kind of a teacher, if that is the role of that document. That has to come through in the way I craft, and that crafting therefore must reflect what I think is credibility. So that, I think, is the way I would look at telling a story in a corporate sense.